regarding the team.
So again, we are online. Hello.
नहीं उन्हें म्यूट करी चले उन्हें की आवाज नहीं आ रही
ग्रुप जो मैसेज करे से
म्यूट कर आवाज अच्छी पे ता पढ़ायो सर
हां
हां कंटिन्यू करो
ओके अगेन वी हैव रीस्टार्टेड सो इन ऑर्थोपेडिक टुडे वी विल डिस्कस जनरल प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ऑर्थोपेडिक्स व्हाट इज ऑर्थोपेडिक्स कैन यू डिफाइन ऑर्थोपेडिक्स सो ऑर्थोपेडिक इज सर्जिकल फील्ड व्हिच डील्स विद द bones and joints and the structures that move the joints means musculoskeletal system all musculoskeletal structures are dealing in arthropods bones joints their diseases their disorders their rheumatoid affections their tumors infections other miscellaneous disorders deformities maybe congenital maybe acquired So all these. Yes. So.
Sir, we are hearing.
Yes. Forward, नहीं हो रहा है. Stuck हो गया है. Forward.
ठीक है पढ़ाता
हूँ ओके तो हाउ कैन यू डिफाइन ऑर्थोपेडिक The orthopedic is surgical field which deals with the fractures and dislocations of the limbs, upper limb, lower limb. Okay, and the structures are orthopedic also deals with the musculoskeletal structures, muscles, nerves, vessels, even vessels. Okay. So what is the symbol of orthopedic? Symbol of orthopedic. Symbol, you can describe broken plant supported by splint. Broken plant supported by splint, because this symbol describe that if there is fracture, we can immobilize the fractures by splint. So symbol of the orthopedist is just like this. Broken plant supported by a splint. If you observe this symbol anywhere, any page, you think about that there is discussion of orthopedics. So that is the symbol of orthopedics. In exams mostly asked, what is the symbol of orthopedics? What is the definition of the orthopedics? What is included in orthopedics? Because mostly the students, even doctors. Or even paramedics or other staff, medical related or non-medical related, they say that orthopedic only there is treatment of the fractures. हड्डियों के fractures हो जाएं फिर उनको कोई जोड़े तो यही है बस orthopedic. So that is not sufficient definition. An orthopedic, yes, fractures are dealt, dislocations are dealt, but also there are other disorders. Maybe congenital, maybe acquired, maybe traumatic, maybe tumorous, maybe infected, maybe rheumatoid, septic, maybe degenerative disorders, age-related, such as osteoarthritis, and also miscellaneous groups such as diabetic foot. You can think about that. What orthopedician can serve in diabetic foot? In diabetic foot, the orthopedic surgeon. Will debridement or amputation in madura foot fungal infection of the foot, there is discharge of the tiny particles, blood particles from the sinuses. So that is fungal infection, mostly occurs in farmers. So that will be also dealt by antifungal treatment and also surgical curettage by orthopedic surgeon. There are different also other groups which can be dealt by orthopedic surgeon. So now we can discuss about fracture. What is fracture? You can define fracture as breakage of the bone, but the fracture may be in slide one. The fracture is described as discontinuation in the cortex, discontinuation in the bone. You can see the bone is discontinued. The continuity of the bone is disturbed. So figure of tibia and fibula, fracture of both bones. In both bones, the continuity of the bones is disturbed. This is called fracture. So what are the gift from Zoom, running out of time. It's running out of time. Yes, that's fine. So we are discussing the fractures. What is fracture? Discontinuity of the bone, discontinuity in the cortex of the bone. Okay, there are different types of the fractures. What are the different types of the fractures? There may be closed fractures. You will say closed fractures means no any bone. There is no fracture. There is open fracture means fracture is associated with wound. In second slide, there is bone exposed from the wound. That is open fracture. And if there is a slight penetration, that can be called as closed fracture. There is other term that is dislocation. This joint is of shoulder. And what is dislocation? Can you define dislocation? Dislocation is the complete apartness of the articulating surfaces. Complete apartness. If there is some contact in between the articulating surfaces, that will be called as subluxation. Subluxation in second step. So dislocation is the complete apartness of the articulating surfaces. Okay, in case of this shoulder slide. Again, shoulder slide, there is some contact between the articulating surface. This is called as subluxation. These terms are asked mostly in exam. What is dislocation? These students mostly mix the definition of fracture and dislocation. Dislocation occurs in the joints. The articulating surfaces become apart, and subluxation is still contact, and also there may be sprain. What is sprain? That is the ligament injury. This ankle slide, the lateral ligament, talofibular ligament, calcaneofibular ligament, the fibers are torn partially. So if muscle or ligament fibers are torn, this is called a sprain. Ligament fibers. Ligaments in the case of joint. Okay. If there is a muscle tear, the term will be called a sprain. Sprain, ST. Ligament injury is sprain. So these are the, this is the elaboration about the fracture. That now we will discuss what are the causes of fractures. What are the different patterns of fracture? And what are the different grading of the fractures? What is the displacement of the fractures we will discuss? So what are the causes of fractures? Mostly trauma and pathology, and overuse, stress. So direct trauma on the distal phalanx by hammer, resulting into fracture of the distal phalanx. The cause may be direct trauma. The cause of the fracture may be direct trauma. Fall of the patient or fall of the person on the ground, on the elbow, there may be fracture of the olecranon. Or this is direct injury. Other cause of fracture is indirect injury. in that twisting injury occurs and fracture can occur. In this type of injury, the fracture mostly occur in spiral fracture. What are the different shapes of the fractures? We will also discuss different shapes. So in this case, a spiral fracture occurs. In the slide, foot slide, the second metatarsal is a hairline fracture. This is March fracture. This occurs mostly in forces, policemen, rangers, army recruits, in which prolonged standing occurs, and the fracture occurs in the mostly in the second metatarsal. In MCQ, the question is put that stress fracture can occur in first, second, third, fourth, fifth metatarsal. What is right? Second metatarsal is the side for stress fracture. In other causes of fracture pathology, in this femur slide, soft rock entric level, mostly cystic lesions can occur or any growth. Most common site is this subtrochanteric level, and fracture can occur without any trauma. When person, old age person mostly walk or even stand, there become fracture because bone is already weak due to pathology. And pathology may be tumorous condition and also prolonged standing, and also pathology may be metabolic disorder such as humerus fracture. This occurs in osteoporosis. Osteoporosis, humerus fracture. Osteoporosis bones become weak, and fracture can occur in routine daily life without any trauma history. So these are the causes of fractures. You can also imagine. You can also give answer. The causes of the fractures are maybe accidents, okay? Accidents, trauma, pathology, infections, stress, metabolic disorders. All these are the causes of fractures. Okay, what are the patterns of fracture? Patterns of fracture. The pattern may be, this bone is called carpal bone. What are the different carpals? You can revise scaphoid, lunate, trapezoid, piscifer, then trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, amate. So mostly scaphoid fracture can occur by fall on the ground. There is hairline fracture of the scaphoid. In other, there is complete fracture of the scaphoid. So when there is hairline fracture, one can miss the fracture on the day one. Patient complain of pain and swelling of the wrist joint. But on the day one, the fracture can be missed because only there is hairline fracture. But after 1 week or after a few days, again x-ray repeated, then the fracture becomes obvious. Why this occurs? Initially, patient will be very anxious that on the day one there was no fracture, but this is not correct. The fracture line become more obvious because due to decalcification at the fracture site. Decalcification occurs at the fracture site and the fracture becomes more apparent. So fracture of the scaphoid and other, these are also the patterns of fracture, one cortex fracture. In this x-ray, also one cortex fracture, there is also callus. One can say that there may be other any growth in the bone, maybe, but this will be proved by investigation. This is x-ray, but this will be proved by CT scan. CT scan, we will discuss investigations in orthopedics in later on lectures. So this type of slide, there is green stick fracture. These are the different patterns of fracture, hairline, complete, green stick fracture. Green stick fracture occurs in children. Only one cortex of the fracture is involved. One cortex and periosteum is stripped. And for this case, green stick fracture for children, back slave support, immobilization, the different methods for treatment. We also will deal different one lecture on management of the fractures. So we are discussing patterns of the fractures. Green stick fracture, okay, one cortex fracture, and for healing of this type of the fracture, the other side will also be tried to be break fractured. Then there will be complete healing. Other, yes, there is also other shape of the fracture, that is transverse fracture. Transverse fracture, what is transverse fracture? Can you define what is transverse fracture? Such as the long bones, when fracture line runs at right angle, to the long axis of the bone. When fracture line runs at right angle to the long axis of the bone, this is called transverse fracture. And what is oblique fracture? When fracture line, just like, when fracture line runs at, there is formation of angle more than 30 degree at the fracture site. Formation of angle more than 30 degree at the fracture site. This is called as oblique fracture. And what is a spiral fracture? This like a spiral fracture. The fracture line runs circumferentially in the bone. So different shapes are the fractures: green stick, transverse fracture, oblique fracture, the spiral fracture. We are discussing patterns of the fractures. Comminuted fracture. What is comminuted fracture? When fracture, at the fracture site, there are multiple pieces, means more than three pieces. That is called comminuted fracture. This is called, in slide 14 number, this is wedge fracture, formation of the wedge, triangular wedge at the fracture site. And 1, 2, that is comminuted fracture of the diaphysis of the femur. Okay, in second slide, there is fracture, one segment, long segment is present in second. This is called as double fracture or segmental fracture. Double fracture or segmental fracture. So what is double fracture? One fracture occurs at two places in the same bone. In the same bone, with two places, this is called as segmental fracture or double fracture, comminuted fracture. Okay. In case of hip joint femur, this fracture is called, yes, like impacted fracture, when fracture neck occurs and that becomes impacted in the femoral head. This is impacted fracture, or this is displaced fracture. Impacted fracture, then that is undisplaced, and this is displaced fracture in the femur neck. So this description of the fracture is most important for treatment of the fractures. If fracture is undisplaced, okay, preserve the femoral head and you can do a screen. If the fracture is displaced and in case of old age, you can remove the whole femoral head. So other types of the fractures, patterns of the fractures, in case of vertebrates, vertebral collapse occurs by fall from the height. Vertebral collapse, mostly lumbar and lower thoracic. So lumbar collapse can occur. Lumbar collapse, this is called as compression fracture. Also due to fall from the height, there is also fracture of the calcaneum. When there is history of fall from height, mostly we suspect that there may be fracture of the heel bone. Heel bone or calcaneus, calcaneal bone. Also, there are different other options or the displacements of the fractures. These are called as traction injuries, such as base of the fifth metatarsal traction. There is insertion of peroneus brace. Here insertion of the peroneus brace is in case of twisting injury. This piece becomes avulsed from the base of the fifth metatarsal. patient will complain of pain, swelling, difficulty in walking, limping. X-ray will prove that there is a fracture of the base of the fifth metatars. Also, there is, in case of knee joint, there may be avulsion of the tibial tuberosity. Which tendon is inserted in the tibial tuberosity? Quadriceps femoris. That tendon is attached here and that become avulsed. This is called as avulsion. Avulsion fracture of the tibial tuberosity. Also, there may be avulsion of the suprapatellar pole, any pole. Any pole of the patella can be avulsed in this graph. Suprapatellar avulsion. Also, there is avulsion of the lesser trochanter. Lesser trochanter, which muscle is attached at the lesser trochanter? Which muscle? Iliopsoas. Iliopsoas muscle is attached at the lesser trochanter, that is the flexor of the hip. So, what will happen? Avulsion of the lesser trochanter. So, these are the different shapes of the fractures, that hairline, comminuted, segmental, compression, impacted fracture, traction fracture. There is also a gamekeeper's thumb injury, in which the ligament injury occurs in the metacarpophalangeal joint, and also there is avulsion, and also there is avulsion of the first metacarpophalangeal. Also, there may be depressed fracture. So, fall of heavy object on the head or skull. There also deals. There is a depressed fracture. In this slide, there is intra-articular injuries, the fracture intra-articular, and so intra-articular fracture will complicate into secondary osteoarthritis. This joint, when there is fracture near the joint, there may be formation of hemarthrosis, the collection of blood in the joint. When there is fracture as well as dislocation, this is called fracture dislocation. Fracture dislocation of the shoulder, dislocation and fracture. And other, there may be complicated fracture named as complicated, because in case of this is elbow, supracondylar fracture, and the corner of the fracture can compress on the brachial artery. So blood flow will be impaired and there will be ischemic changes in the forearm. This is called complicated fracture. When fracture associated with any complication, ischemia, nerve injury, other. There are different parts of the bones, such as epiphyses, epiphyseal plate, metaphyses, diaphyses. These are the different, I think you must be aware from these parts or level of the fractures. A fracture occurs in the joint, epiphysis. Fracture can occur in the epiphyseal plate. Epiphyseal plate, in case of epiphyseal plate or growth plate, there is also other classification of the epiphyseal plate injuries we will discuss later on. A fracture can occur at the metaphyseal area, fracture can occur at the diaphyseal. So, diaphyseal fracture or the tibia, this level is femur. Supracondylar fracture of the femur, fracture, neck femur, fracture of the greater trochanter. So, diagnosis of the fracture is easy, because an exam in short cases when you will be provided X-ray, that's our diagnosis. So, very simple. Sir, this is fracture of the femur, supracondylar limb. Sir, this is fracture of the neck of the femur. Very easy to diagnose fractures radiologically. Okay. So these are also different levels of the fracture. In this case, the wrist, you see, wrist fracture near the wrist. This is called as a specific name, Colles fracture, C-O-L-L-E. Colles fracture, what is Colles fracture? We will discuss different fractures of the upper limb pollicis fracture, fractures of the lower. Today we are discussing general principles of the fractures, different behaviors. So fracture, you can describe the fracture in the distal fragment. Distal fragment displaced dorsally means there will be pollicis fracture. If distal fragment of the radius displaced on the palmar side, that will be called as Smith fracture. If distal fragment intra-articular fracture, that will be called as Barton fracture. Barton. So different names. Pollicis fracture is very common. Or different levels. And displacement. How can you describe the displacement of the fracture? Displacement of the fracture. Suppose in case of femur, the displacement of the fractures will be described. Which the displacement of the fractures will be described in case of distal fragment. Distal fragment. The distal fragment in which direction displaces? You see, in case of a third femur, the distal fragment of the femur displaces posteriorly. Anteriorly is patella. The distal fragment, the fracture is displaced posteriorly. The fracture is displaced laterally. So displacement. Displacement is described in case of distal fragment. So I think you are getting my points that in general principles, what is included, you can start from orthopedics, what is included in orthopedics, what is the concept of persons, what is the concept of world, what is the concept of orthopedic surgeons or in medical terminology, what is the symbol of orthopedics. What are the causes of arthropathy? What are the different shapes of the arthropathy? What different types? Okay. So displacement of the fractures, you can describe in case of distal fragment. In femur, you can describe the distal fragment. So fracture is displaced anteriorly. Fracture is displaced laterally. Means distal fragment is going laterally. So there are also other patterns. There may be formation of angles at the fracture site. Angles in case of femur, okay, tibia. The angle after 5 to 10 degrees, the angle can be accepted, but more angles, the angles will not be accepted. Okay, so different shapes of the fractures. Now you see this slide there in which leg, tibia, fibula. The tibia is coming out from the fracture site. This is called as open fracture.
नहीं वो पहले time लेना पड़ना नहीं आगे कोई गई सी time लिया सी फिर उन्होंने बाज देखिया सी.
The open fracture. What is the grading? How can you grade classify open fractures? When this classification of open fractures, closed fracture. That is very simple. The skin is intact. Okay. The classification, mandatory to classify the fractures because the management depends upon classification. If there is closed fracture, okay, internal fixation. If there is open fracture, our open fracture depends upon grade 1, 2, 3. Grade 1, very minute wound. Grade 2, bone is exposed, but periosteum is intact, no severe contamination. Grade 3, 1PC, depends upon contamination, depends upon exposure of the bone, depends upon size of the wound. So depends upon circulation. If distal circulation is damaged, compressed, ischemic, that will be called as fracture is type C. Type C means vascular insufficiency. So different classifications, Gustilo-Anderson classification, this is the name of our open fracture, Gustilo classification. Okay. Now we will take your test by these slides. Causes of fracture, direct trauma. Okay. By hit, by injury, open fracture. Okay. So this slide, X-ray slide, can you describe what is this? Sir, this is fracture of the tibia, diaphyseal, but transverse fracture, because fracture line runs at right angle to the long axis of the bone. Transverse fracture. Second slide, not so clear. Third slide, the joint, the articulating surfaces are apart from each other. So this is called dislocation. Dislocation, joint apartness. What are the causes of dislocation? Maybe trauma, maybe infection, maybe ligament laxity. Ligament laxity, the joint can become dislocated. Okay. Oh, crush fracture, crush injury of the forearm, and with ulna is intact and the radius is also superior radial ulnar joint dislocated and there is fracture, crushing. Okay. This slight shoulder fracture of the greater tuberosity and also dislocation, fracture dislocation of the. Achha, this slight lower fracture at two places in the same bone. This is called a segmental fracture or double fracture. Fracture of the radius ulna and ulna transverse and radius oblique fracture means there is formation of angle more than 30 degree. Okay. Traction injuries. Fracture of the base of the fifth metatarsal, traction injury. Fracture of the vertebral collapse, maybe due to fall or mostly due to osteoporosis. Ankle fracture dislocation, ankle fracture dislocation, ankle means tibia fibula fracture dislocation, ankles. Okay, wedge fracture of the tibia. So you will be provided x-rays, you can diagnose. There are different types of epiphysis. Epiphysis, joint line epiphysis, that is pressure epiphysis, and other is traction epiphysis, means greater trochanter, lesser trochanter. And second slide, base of the fifth metatarsal, tibial tuberosity, calcaneal epiphysis. So these are the joint epiphysis in the joint. That will be called pressure epiphysis. And the epiphysis with muscle attachment occurs, that is called traction epiphysis. Leaves these slides, growth plate injuries, last slide, growth plate injuries, fracture of the neck of the femur. Okay, growth plate injuries, grade 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, grade 1 and 2, joint is not involved, grade 3 and 4, joint is involved. So there to be called as Anderson classification of growth plate injuries. Okay. Crushing injury of the epiphyseal plate. You are under graduate level. These things are most important for postgraduate levels, and they will be enforced to learn these things, growth plate injuries. At your level, undergraduate level, you can, you must know the what are the causes of fractures, what are the types of fractures, what are the types of fractures. The types of the fractures, depending upon the bone, pillows are open, and depending upon the shape of the fracture. Transverse fracture, oblique fracture, comminuted fracture, okay, compression fracture, okay, segmental fracture. So all these are the types of fractures. What are the causes of fractures from pathology? What are the displacement of the fractures? What are the different shapes of the fractures? What are the pressure epiphyses? What is the traction epiphyses? You must have awareness about these things. So growth plate injuries, grade 1, totally displaced. Then grade lateral condyle. These things are most important for postgraduate levels. So in case of fractures, when there is fracture not united correctly in lower slide on right side, the fracture of the distal radius, Colles fracture, I think, that is healed not properly, accurately. Therefore, growth of that radius bone is restricted and ulna is protruding forward, growing. So, there will be deformity of the wrist joint due to male union of the fractures. Fractures, you can also discuss the complications of the fractures. Separate lecture on the complications of the fractures. These slides show trauma to the bone, healing stages of bone healing. When trauma occurs, there is fracture, there is muscle stripping, skin stripping, and bone also become fracture. There will be hematoma formation, stage of hematoma formation. Then third slide, stage of soft callus formation. Cells appear and cellular proliferation occurs and vessels. So soft callus formation. And again, fourth and fifth slide, there is hard callus formation. And then last corner, remodeling. So there are the different stages of bone healing, means trauma, hematoma formation, soft callus, hard callus, and then remodeling. You must know the names of these stages of the bone healing, means trauma, resultant fracture, then in the initial hours, hematoma, then few weeks, soft callus, then few months, hard callus, and then years, remodeling. Remodeling, all these procedures are seen. A classification of the fractures, different classification. This is a new classification, means by numbers. Humerus is number 1, radius ulna 2, femur 3, tibia fibula 4. Again, these are divided into 3 parts. A, B, C means proximal part, middle part, lower part. So these are the classification according to this classification is called as AO classification. AO classification. If you are working on computer, you can classify the fracture. If there is fracture of the distal humerus, means bone is 1, and there is a third part, distal part is 3rd. And if joint is involved, that will be called as C. So you can label all these fractures according to the level of fracture, level of the bone, level of the fracture, and shape of the fracture. If there is simple fracture, means A. If there is a wedge fracture or comminuted, the fracture is B. If there is intra-articular fracture, joint damage, the fracture will be C. Now, if tibia fibula fracture, means you will number is 4. 4, 3 means description of the tibia fracture, and 3 means distal part. So you can describe in these methods by AO classification. You can only number. You can number the bones. Humerus 1, radius ulna 2, femur 3rd, and tibia fibula 4. Again divided into 3 parts. So this is again cleared open fractures classification. Grade 1, grade only slight point at the fracture site or slight laceration. Grade 2, fracture is more than 2 cm or 5 cm. Bone is exposed, but not so, wound is not so contaminated. And grade 3A, 3B, 3C. When cases or patients come at the trauma center, we label that fracture is grade 3A. So we can diagnose that 3A means bone is more than 5 cm, wound is more than 5 cm. There is some contamination of the wound, but periostem of the bone is intact, that is 3A. If periostem is lifted up from the bone, that will be called as 3B, and severe contamination, and size of the wound is much more. And grade 3C, when there is vascular supply is damaged, the fracture is called as grade 3C, and we'll try to refer the patient to the vascular surgeon for proper surgery or management. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Sir, thank you.
Question in the answer upon the
Balaga question, which much I have.